Hello, everyone. Welcome for another episode of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays. I'm your host, Swetha Mannepalli. Today, I'm here with Prasanth Tammiraju, Technical Director for Data and AI at Quadrant Technologies. Thank you for coming to our studios and hanging out with us, Prasanth.
Thank you very much, Swetha. It's great being here. Thank you for having me.
Perfect. So before we get started, Prasanth, would you like to tell us a little about what is Quadrant Technologies? What do you guys do in the Microsoft Fabric space? And how are you helping customers?
Quadrant Technologies is a Fabric feature partner. It is one of the top partners, early adoption of Fabric. So where we are experts in migration, where we have a product, QMigrator, which helps customers in migrating from any database, heterogeneous, homogeneous. And we are also pretty strong in data analytics, serving our customers across various industries today. And also we are having AI solutions where we are helping our customers across the industries and across the world.
Perfect. So, again, to learn more about how you are skilling up your employees, do you have anybody certified within Quadrant Technologies? And how did you even think about the skilling path? What really helped in that initiative?
Absolutely. I think skilling our employees is one of the topmost priority for us, where we have to be at par on the technical excellence and the product growth, where we have to focus on how the engineering team is accelerating the features. Mm-hmm. So we have ensured all the measures are taken, like the Reactor session, the FabCon sessions, or training upskilling through the Azure paths that we have, the learning paths. Mm-hmm. So we do have close to 200 plus DP600 certified professionals, and also DP700 too.
Wonderful. That is amazing. Thank you for helping our customers at scale. Today, we're going to dive deep into one of the most talked about features within Microsoft Fabric, real-time intelligence. Mm-hmm. So real-time intelligence, what I would like to learn from you, helping customers, Prasanth, is it a feature or a workload that is only specific to niche customers? Mm-hmm. Or any organization could take advantage of the real-time intelligence? And maybe talk to us a little more about it.
So Fabric real-time intelligence is a real game changer. It is not for a specific domain or a specific industry, wherever any customer who is looking to handle the streaming data. Mm-hmm. So this is coming to a savior. It's a great feature within Fabric, where we are able to see the customer adoption increase day by day. Mm-hmm. And the ease with which they're able to handle the streaming data, identify the anomalies, plug in those relevant models, and see how effectively they can alert, then trigger the notifications, and even have a seamless integration between Azure as well as the other systems like Power Automate and AI workloads is really a great game changer for the customers.
You got me interesting with adding AI component to RTI. So can you give us a use case or a scenario where you would leverage RTI, but also complement it with AI? So just give me an example or a use case that you might have worked on.
So definitely, I think we have assisted one of our customers in the manufacturing sector, mm-hmm. where they had multiple personas, one of them being the plant technicians, mm-hmm. who were handling the IoT sensors, how the data is flowing into the system. And they had the operations team, where they were effectively setting up the entire Fabric RTI architecture and the integrations between the components. And along with that, the plant supervisor or the manager is using the Copilot Studio in order to ensure that they do the right RCA, the anomaly detection, and to get to the root cause of what has actually happened, and how they're easily able to understand the potential problem or even have some predictive intelligence with respect to the analytics that is built on top of this.
Perfect. So gone are the days where you're really struggling to get a handle around your data estate. You're really taking one step ahead with a platform like Microsoft Fabric, where you're not just bringing the data, like you said, mm-hmm. IoT sensor data, streaming data, and not just using OneLake as a storage mechanism, but also using it for predictive analytics with using all the other Lego pieces like Copilot Studio, like you mentioned. Mm-hmm. Would love to see a demo, mm-hmm. because at Fabric Tech Talk Fridays, we just don't do the talk. Prasanth, let's get to the laptop and show us what you got.
Sure, Swetha. So let me talk a little bit about the use case context. Mm-hmm. So as I mentioned, this manufacturing customer has three personas, the plant technician and the operations team and the plant supervisor. So fabric RTI, so these are all the core components that we have as part of the architecture, the event stream. So the event stream allows us to ingest all the data from the event hubs into the fabric RTI environment, where you see not only the flow, the delta sync that happens, and then we process that information into a lake house or a KQL database, right? So where we can do the further downstream processing. And if you go to an event house database, so this gives you a dashboard, which where we can easily understand what are all the databases that are present. So here, this is handling the CNC IoT sensor data. So if you see the sensor tab, where the complete data that is being loaded from the event stream is getting pushed into the event house DB with a certain frequency. And then we are able to see all the details, let it be the temperature, pressure, all the core data about the failures that are passing on to this, where we can apply certain KQL queries on top of this event house DB in order to generate the right kind of insights which we are looking for. So we do have the detailed data types and the columns that are required, which we can change. And the next powerful feature as part of Fabric RTI is a real-time dashboard, which allows us to view the data and in motion. And it also allows us to see the real-time changes that are happening across these charts. And we can generate a custom query easily and create those charts effectively, which are quite powerful. And we can set the alerting on top of this, where I can just create that, what it can be a frequency or the pull within an hour, or the refresh rate can be continuous, or we can do a viewing as well as editing. So there are a lot of features which are helping the customers to just monitor this as a control view for them, and effectively monitor that. Now going to that plant supervisor, now that there is an issue that has happened and there is an alert that has been triggered, now the plant manager can just go through this Copilot studio, where we have already set the knowledge data set for the lake house. And on top of it, we have an AI search, which allows us to do the indexing. And he'll be able to give more granular text-driven prompts, and he'll be able to get very detailed answers about what has happened in that particular context of the failure. So for example, he's asking a question, how does the temperature variation correlate with a sensor failure? So he's just trying to get more information around that. So it just provides you the detailed response. What is the overheating? How does the failure actually cause the problem? And then he gets the, what are the temperature range at which it is going to fail, etc. And also he can do what are the core frequent conditions that it might fail. So this kind of ease of integration between the RTI as well as Copilot Studio really helps the customers in bringing out the right insights, which are quite real time, as well as handling the data in motion and the streaming data, which is quite effective, as well as making sure that they have the actionable insights in front of them.
This is fantastic, Prasanth. So what I understood is it's not just being reactive like we used to be. Now it's both reactive as well as proactive. An issue happened, but how are you proactively taking it to the next level, identifying the issue, but also acting towards it?
Absolutely.
So the demo is really fantastic. Thank you so much for sharing that with us. Now, if organizations, whoever is planning to use RTI, what is your key takeaway for them to get started on their RTI journey?
So absolutely. I mean, now in today's world, it's all segregated and the isolated workloads are quite difficult for us to handle. Mm-hmm. So organizations who are trying to ensure that they handle the streaming data effectively need to hop onto a Fabric RTI. So that it's going to be a single SaaSified application, SaaSified approach for them. And within this single copy of data, within one lake, how effectively they can apply the right models and make sure they can generate those alerts and notifications within a quick time would be very, very helpful for the organizations. And also the AI workloads, the integration with Copilot Studio or AI Foundry and other workloads will really help them to scale their applications at a faster pace, as well as making it more flexible and scalable for them.
This is, see, one thing to really understand is we're not just, again, you come for a service, you stay for the platform is the new mantra that we want to go with. So it's come for RTI, but you're really getting the full platform as a offering, meaning you're getting Azure AI Foundry, you're using Copilot Studio, you're using Microsoft Fabric. So these things really work together out of the box. Did you have to do any customizations when using Copilot Studio, or most of the things are out of the box for your use case?
For this use case, mostly it's out of the box, but we had to make sure we did the fine tuning and make sure we gave the right prompts and then fine tune with respect to a few changes. But pretty much everything is out of the box. We just had the integration in place, and it is a very, very quick implementation that we implemented for the customer.
Perfect. So this is, if we want to tag this as a use case, it is anomaly detection using IoT sensors within Microsoft Fabric, again, leveraging RTI and all the goodness of AI.
Absolutely.
Perfect.
That's right.
Thank you so much for sharing this with us and hanging out with us today in the studios. Really appreciate your time, Prasanth.
My pleasure. Thank you very much for having me here.
Thank you, everyone, for watching. If you found this video valuable, don't forget, hit that like button.
If this is your first time visiting the Microsoft Fabric YouTube channel, be sure to smash that subscribe button.
Drop a comment below on what you'd like to see on future episodes of Fabric Tech Talk Fridays.
That's it for today. See you all next Friday for another deep dive into Microsoft Fabric.